Over the last 2 weeks, I've been pushing ChatGPT's image generator to its absolute limits, comparing it to every major alternative that's out there in order to uncover what truly sets it apart. In this video, I'm going to share 12 game-changing applications that will fundamentally transform how you create content from this day forward. If you're new here and you enjoy AI content, then be sure to hit that subscribe button. And I also created a free library of over 30 proven image generation prompts to help you create stunning images just like these. You'll find it in the link in the description below. Let's quickly break down what makes ChatGPT's image generator different from other AI tools out there. First, it's built in directly into ChatGPT, which means that you don't need any other tools or subscriptions in order to use it. If you're using ChatGPT already, then you already have access to it. Second, it has incredible text accuracy. It's great for creating social media posts, infographics, or anything else with text elements. And third, it maintains character consistency. If you generate a character and then you want to modify it or place it in a different scene, the AI remembers it and keeps it consistent. Let's dive into the use cases. Let's start with something incredibly useful, product mockups. If you want to create an image, you can either click this button or just say create image. I'm going to upload a basic product image of a Nike cap, and I'll ask ChatGPT to place it on a model in front of the Sydney Opera House. That's insanely good, which means that you can basically take any product that you like, place it on a model in front of iconic places without having costly photo shoots. Well, let's check what happens if I ask ChatGPT to actually create also a word. So in this case, I'll ask for Sydney in Helvetica font. Now, this is very clean and miles better than it was still a few months ago. Now, let's take the exact same character and place him onto a different scene, Central Park, New York. Now, do you see how the character pretty much stays consistent and the scene looks also very realistic, which is great. You could literally do this with any product, sunglasses, handbags, watches, and place them in any aspirational setting that really connects with your audience. Next up is silhouette SVGs, and these are absolute gold for designers. They're perfect for branding, social media, and any professional marketing materials you might need. Let me show you with a photo of myself. I want to transform this into a clean black silhouette SVG. Wow, look at that. The AI really nailed my profile with those really clean, crisp lines. This is exactly the kind of silhouette that you can instantly use as part of your personal brand, slap it onto your website as a logo or as a watermark, or even print it on your business cards. Next up is reimagining classic memes with your own custom twist. And this is absolutely massive for social media content that actually connects with people. Let me show you just how powerful this is. I'm going to take the grumpy cat meme and give it my own custom spin. Well, that's amazing. It really keeps the essence of the grumpy cat meme, but gives it its own spin. And the writing is also very clean and resembles the typical meme font, which is perfect for sharing across multiple platforms. Use case number four is turning regular photos into artistic masterpieces, which is perfect for unique profile pictures, social media posts, or even gifts. I'll use this selfie as an example, and I'm going to ask for a classic Renaissance painting vibe. So those dramatic portraits that you see in a museum with good lighting and rich colors. Wow, that's so good. It completely transformed my image into what could be a legitimate oil painting from centuries ago. This is a great use case if you want to have a profile picture that really makes you stand out, or if you want to use it as a gift for friends and family. You could even print those on a canvas and hang them on a wall at your house. Next is generating logo concepts, which is super powerful if you're launching a business or you need fresh branding ideas. And what I love about this is how quickly you can visualize different concepts that would generally take days of back and forth with a designer. And I'm going to create a sleek, modern coffee shop logo with specific colors and elements to show you just how powerful this is. Look at the quality of the concept. The color combination fits really nicely and the font is also really clean. So now I'm going to ask it to remove the background as a next step. Perfect, that was basically one click, and now I can use it for any type of marketing material. Use case number six is creating brand consistent ad creatives, a game changer for marketeers who need to maintain brand guidelines while rapidly testing new ad designs. And let me show you something really powerful. I'm going to import Facebook's official brand guidelines that are publicly available, and I'm going to ask it to create an ad for their business suite tool that perfectly matches their corporate identity. Okay, this is even better. I mean, it even shows me my potential ICPs and asks me which one I want to go for. So in this case, I'll just go for the digital creator on the move. Well, look at this. I mean, if this isn't good, then I don't know what is, because it perfectly captures the Facebook signature blue, their minimalist design. And I also love the phone here that basically shows how your reach and engagement increases. So, I mean, just this feature alone can save you so much time. I mean, this could have literally come from their design team. Moving on to creating event promotions and posters that are perfect for event organizers, musicians, or anyone hosting gatherings. I'll generate a vibrant music festival poster that captures the summer vibe while ensuring that the important event details are also displayed. It's fantastic to see how balanced all of these elements are. The date is really clean and sticks out, and the location as well. And you see that it's a festival, people are dancing, so that's really on point. Use case number 8 is creating a personalized AI avatar. And this is a total game changer for creating a consistent personal brand. I'll transform my regular headshot into a 3D pixel animated character that I can use across all of my social media profiles. That's really good. I mean, look how it maintained my key features, my earrings, the way how I wear my hair, the shirt as well, the location where I'm sitting, but then it just transformed it into a 3D character. The lighting of the picture is also really good. And if you look at it and you know me, you'll probably recognize me, but still it gives it kind of that creative edge. Next is generating website layout concepts, which is a complete game changer for web designers and business owners who need quick professional mockups. I'll create a complete e-commerce homepage layout for a planned shop, including all the essential sections like navigation, hero area, product categories, all in a cohesive green design. Wow, this is really good. I mean, look at how it perfectly structured the products here, how it used the green so it like fits with the plant theme. I feel like there's also a great balance of images and text. The hero section also looks very clean with home, shop, about, contact. You can use this to visualize your website before building it, or just quickly test out different layout concepts. Use case number 10 is creating a software feature infographic, which is perfect for SaaS companies and also app developers who need to clearly communicate their product's capabilities in a visually appealing way. For example, I'll create an infographic for a project management tool that highlights the key features and is perfectly formatted for landing pages or social media. This looks really good. I mean, the four features are displayed in a really clean way, each with an icon, and I feel like it really captures the typical tech style. The layout is also instantly digestible, so people immediately know what your tool is about. Use case number 11 is creating YouTube thumbnails. And as someone who makes a ton of thumbnails myself, this is honestly one of my favorite ones. Let me show you a super practical approach. What I'm going to do is upload one of my existing thumbnails and then ask it for a specific color change so I can test out different versions and check what just works best. I look similar, but definitely not good enough to use. It still has certain challenges to recreate a person exactly the same. So here's a much better approach. You just take the background picture and add it in without the person, and then you just ask for a color change. So let me show you. Now this is much better. That's something I could even actually use. So the text really stays intact. It just mainly changes the colors. That's perfect for quickly testing out different color schemes to see which one of them actually gets more clicks without having to rebuild the entire thumbnail from scratch. For our final use case, let's look at creating before and after comparison images, which is perfect for showcasing transformation. I'll demonstrate it with a garden transformation using a somewhat abandoned outdoor space as my starting point. Look at that transformation.
The AI pretty much maintained the same space, but it just rearranged it with flowers, with a clean pathway, and just really vibrant, lush greenery. There are even labels that make it really clear before and after to highlight the contrast between the images, which is extremely useful for interior designers, fitness coaches, YouTubers, anyone who really wants to showcase a transformation can use this in their marketing materials to instantly communicate their value.
I hope that these 12 use cases have shown you how powerful ChatGPT's AI image generator can be for your projects. And don't forget to grab my free prompt library using the link in the description below. You'll find way more prompts than you've seen in this video. And do let me know in the comments below what other AI tools you'd like me to cover next. And if you found this video helpful, then be sure to hit that like button. I'll post new videos every week in order to help you stay ahead of the AI curve. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.